Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Colin.
Hello, everybody. This is Nora. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Nora, have you ever heard of Frederick Sanger?
Frederick Sanger, 好像感觉听过，但是又记得不是特别清楚。
Well, he's a biochemist who died at age 95.He had the rare distinction of winning the Nobel Prize twice.
啊，你这么一说呢，我就有一些印象了。他是一名少见的拿过两次诺贝尔奖的生物化学家，主要是在胰岛素，还有就是蛋白质序列上做了重要的贡献。
Exactly. But I'm a little surprised that you have heard of him. He's not a familiar name to most people.
Yeah.I think I read his story from an obituary a few years ago.
Ah, yeah, that makes sense. An obituary is an article about somebody's life and achievements that is printed in a newspaper soon after they die.
没错 ,obituary 就是指的新闻上的附告。13年他去世的时候呢，泰晤士报、纽约时报还有自然杂志都登了同一条附告。而且连诺贝尔委员会的官网上也放上一张黑白照以示悼念。直至今日呢，他在生物化学上的成就也还在沿用。所以今天呢，我们就来一起聊一聊这位一代传奇。
今天呢，给大家送个超棒的福利，早安英文会员课程的7天免费体验权限，只有10个名额哦。同时呢，大家也可以加入早安英文的 Telegram 社群，来群里和我们一起交流。社群地址和7天会员的免费领取链接都放在评论区了，欢迎你来。
那 Colin, 我们刚刚讲到啊，桑格先生是一代传奇，主要是体现在哪些方面呢？
Well, Sanger's methods opened up the means for modern biotechnology.
Open up means. Open up 指的就是打开。Means 在这里不是指的意义啊。在单词的 mean 后面加上了一个 s, 意思就是表方式、手段。Open up means 就可以指开辟了路径。所以说桑格先生呢可以说是为现代生物技术开创了新的路径。
Yeah, to put it simply, this equips us with a means to sustain sources of food to support a growing population and to help maintain the health of that population through new drugs.
那其实跟大家说一些生物化学的术语估计大家也很难懂。所以简单来说就是它的方法呢可以让增长的人口啊有足够的食物吃，而对于人类的健康也做出了重要贡献。不过每一次它的实验我想都肯定是经过了漫长的时间才能够取得成果吧。
Right. When he worked on insulin, it took him 12 years of work in a laboratory to come up with a solution.
Insulin, 这个单词的意思呢比较学术啊，指的是胰岛素。他之前呢花了12年在实验室仔细的研究胰岛素的精确结构。他得出来一个结论，就是这个毅力我觉得真的是值得我们所有人学习的。
Exactly. This dogged persistence and daily lab work characterized his scientific career.
Alright, 那刚刚 Colin 说到一个单词 dogged, 大家千万不要以为这个单词翻译为是狗狗的。最早起这个单词的使用呢的确是和狗有相关，指的是狗狗的品质。但现在我们用到这个单词 dogged, 就是指顽强的有毅力的。
Yeah.It means the same as determined.
没错，所以 dogged persistence 就是指的顽强的毅力。
Yeah, as he said, of the three main activities involved in scientific research, there's thinking, talking, and doing, he much prefers the last and is probably best at it. He's all right at the thinking, but not much good at the talking.
thinking, 思考 talking, 说话 doing, 做事那桑格先生评价自己啊，是其实是最会实际的做事情，其次是思考，最后呢才是说话。
And Nora much prefers talking than the rest.
没错，我跟桑格先生可能就完全相反啊，毕竟我也是播音节目的主持人嘛，我肯定是最会说了。不过我想啊，是不是也因为他说的比较少，所以反而知道他的人也不多呢？
Well, I think Sanger's lack of fame is largely due to his humble nature and modesty.
Humble 是一个形容词，意思就是谦虚的。那 modesty 是名词，它也是同样的意思，表谦卑的。那其实因为得过两次诺贝尔奖的人嘛，一般名声早就大振了。比如说大家都很熟悉的居里夫人啊。但是桑格的名气不大，其实主要是因为他很谦虚。
Exactly. He commented himself in his autobiography, I was not academically brilliant. The article also makes no mention of the numerous prizes and honors he won.
Biography 其实指的是传记嘛。Autobiography 其实就是自传。就从他的个人的成就来说呢，估计没有人会说他是不优秀的，但是却在他自己的自传里面啊，他就提到他并不能够算作是 academically brilliant， 就是在学术上非常优秀的一个人。那而且对于他赢得的各个奖项啊，他也是只字不提，可以见是一个非常谦虚的人。
Right. As he mentions when he won the Nobel Prize, his effort on research is not to achieve riches or even honor.But rather because he's interested in the work, enjoyed doing it, and felt very strongly that it was worthwhile.
既不是为了想要财富，也不是为了想要荣耀，只不过是觉得一切都是非常值得的。I think he devoted to scientific research only because he has been engaged in the pursuit of knowledge.
Yeah, and like many other scientists, he had experienced some tough times when carrying out experiments, which he described as lean years with no major success.
Lean years. Lean 啊，一般就是形容一个人非常的瘦啊。But if you describe periods of time as lean, you mean that people have less of something, such as money, or they are less successful than they used to be. 指的就是说他们研究成果很少的几年，没有什么突破。就是我在想啊，桑格先生是怎么突破的呢？
Well, he had found that the best antidote was to keep looking ahead.
All right. Antidote.等于是解毒剂啊，在这里指的是解决方式，所以他发现最好的解决方式就是展望未来。我觉得听起来非常的哲学。
Yes, it's quite philosophical. What he means is that when an experiment is a complete failure, it is best not to spend too much time worrying about it, but rather get on with planning and becoming involved in the next one.
I see. 也就是说这失败了的话呀，不要过分的焦虑 ，Don't worry too much， 只要继续计划，好好安排，着手下一次实验就好了。这也就是前面说到的 looking ahead 的意义。
Exactly.
那感觉真的可以从桑格先生身上学习到很多。
But wait, Nora, actually, I noticed that you have been calling him Sir Sangers.
Yeah, for his achievement, he should be called Sir.
Well.That's true, but actually he turned down a knighthood just because he didn't like the idea of being addressed as Sir.
Knighthood 其实就是爵位。那桑格他拒绝接受英国女王授予的爵士勋章啊，理由其实就是因为不喜欢别人称他为 Sir， 也可以说是非常的孩子气了。
Yeah, not many people would refuse an honor such as that.
的确是的。好了，那我们今天谈到的这个一代传奇。Frederick Sanger 就到这里结束了。That's all for today's podcast. This is Nora. Thanks for listening.
This is Colin. See you next time. Bye.
今天的节目就到这里了。大家别忘了去评论区领取我们的福利，早安英文会员课程的7天免费试听名额，只有10个，先到先得。最后，大家如果想加入我们的听众群，也可以在评论区置顶找到我们的 Telegram 社群地址，欢迎你来玩。
This podcast is from Morning English.
学口语就来早安英文。